son.
I have a daughter. I have a little one. I have a little too.
Oh. Once upon a time, there lived a mother and two young children. The family was very poor. They lived in a tiny cottage at the edge of a small village. Though they were poor, they were always happy, for the mother loved her children dearly. The family was never hungry. High on the kitchen shelf sat a very special cooking pot.
Whenever anyone was hungry, mother simply placed the pot upon the stove and said, "Boil, little pot, boil." And within minutes, the tiny pot was refilled with a hot, delicious porridge.
The son would always say, "Mmm,
ah, oh, mother's porridge is best in all the land." And he took a magic pot to show the man.
And the daughter would always say,
"Yes, it is yummy. It's so very tasty in my tummy."
When the family had a lot of porridge, mother would simply say, "This is the magic pot." And the magic pot stopped just as quickly as it has begun. And so it was at each meal. Mother would take the pot down from the hill, place it upon the stove, and say the magic word,
"Boil, little pot, boil."
And in minutes, the pot would be filled with a hot, delicious porridge.
Then the son would say,
"Oh, mother, once again, you have made us a fine meal."
And the daughter would always say,
"So rich. Mother's porridge is truly beautiful."
When at last everyone had their fill of porridge, the mother would say, "Please stop magic pot." Now one day the mother said to the
children, "Dear children, I must go to the village today. I ask only one thing. Do not touch the cooking pot. I shall be home soon."
The son said,
"Dear mother, fear not. I will not touch your cooking pot."
Then the daughter said,
"Oh, mother, of mine, please leave me. I will let your cooking pot."
So mother walked towards the village, leaving her children alone with the magic pot.
After a short while, the son said,
"Sister, dear sister, I am so very hungry. What shall we do?"
"Mother, dear mother, I'm hungry too. I do not know what we should do."
The daughter replied. Then the son said,
"Like it or not, we must touch mother's cooking pot."
So the children placed the magic cooking pot upon the stove, and the daughter said,
"Boil, little pot, boil."
Soon the children filled their bowls with rich, creamy porridge. When the first bowl was empty, the children helped themselves to second helpings.
"Sister, dear sister, I am filled to the top. Tell me, how do you make the magic pot stop?"
"Ah, that is easy. The same that is called magic pot."
But the magic pot did not stop.
"Quick, do something fast. The magic pot must stop. It's boiling over the top."
The son cried out to his sister. So the daughter tried all kinds of words.
"Stop, please stop. Little pot, that will do. No more, I say. Please stop, stop, stop."
The daughter didn't know the magic pot. So the little pot kept making more and more and more porridge. The porridge spilled out of the pot into the tiny house and down the lane towards the village.
"What is this, my friend? I'm bringing all porridge to be ready upon our village today. Stretch your
pots, the bowls, and the stomachs with the rich, creamy porridge. Everyone was happy indeed.
When I returned home, I scolded my daughter and son. I hope that a lesson was learned on that bright sunny day.
If it is not yours, do not touch it. For you may not select what happens, not one little bit.
I learned a lesson on that sunny day. When mothers eat, mothers eat.